Cincinnati's police chief revealing new details on what happened over the weekend when a 16-year-old was spotted with a gun and how long officers were following him before making a move. News 5's John London answering your questions. John?
Yeah, Jack, this square, very safe, according to the new police chief. But he concedes what his department has experienced the past 2 to 3 days reminds him of L.A. Tonight, Chief James Craig on his solution to gun violence.
The new chief says he wants no Band-Aid approach to shootings like the one Saturday night on Fountain Square, not when suturing is called for.
I'm not just saying talk. Let's not just talk about it. Let's get our egos out of it.
Chief James Craig, who met with members of the media for over an hour today, sees intervention and building relationships with troubled youth as essential. Teens like Davon Mullins, who turned 16 this summer and was part of a group that police say tossed guns over a fence to try to breach security at the Black family reunion.
You can't do much of anything without somebody seeing you.
The events coordinator says police tracked the youth as they moved away from Sawyer Point.
If they could have walked in, they would have. They could not. They had to go by devious means in order to do what they did because our security was so tight.
Police tell us tonight, in a perfect world, they would have intervened before the group reached the crowded square in the heart of downtown.
We got 3 guns that night. Certainly.
On the buzz today, Chief Craig told Lincoln Ware they couldn't tell at first who was armed and who wasn't.
It was not until the one officer saw the young man clutching his pocket, not his waist, not holding up his pants, suggesting that there was something he was trying to conceal.
Within 2 minutes of struggle, police say the teen pulled a gun and was shot dead. It has accelerated the chief's time frame for a community-wide approach.
Collectively, we can deal with this issue. I know it. I've been in these situations in the past.
Chief James Craig, he is not a fan of curfews or sweeps or gun buybacks. He says building relationships with young people, wrapping arms around youth in a way that is loving and caring, he says will make a difference over the course of time. He also took offense to a published comment from Prosecutor Joe Dieters. We'll hear more about that tonight at 6. Reporting live at Fountain Square, John London, News 5.
John, we know it's early in the process, but can we be more specific? What would be different about this new youth initiative?
Well, maybe nothing, but here is what Chief James Craig asked tonight. Were we really engaged in the past? Did we really have the full community involved in trying to build a better relationship with young people who are separated from the mainstream? And he wants all elements of the community this time to be involved in, I guess, what you might call a citywide youth initiative.
London, thank you very much.